Unwillingness to accept the views, opinions, belief or behavior that differ from one's own. What do we call this in our language? Intolerance. Apart weak facts and problems like unemployment, poverty, illiteracy, flood mismanagement, there stands yet another biggest and most ignored problem in our country. Intolerance. Many will be relating this term and must be thinking about the Agrima Joshua case, which was on hype. But guys, let me clear you that ye pratha hamare yahan Mughlon ke zamanon se chali aati aa rahi hai. May it be the religious intolerance, the political intolerance or the artistic intolerance. In the next 5 minutes, let us have a brief look onto the matter. Please make sure you watch the video till the end.
भाई समझ के बोल रहा हूँ यार, बुरा लगता है भाई, आप लोग भी जानते हो। प्लीज भाई, मैं भाई समझ के बोल रहा हूँ दोस्तों, प्लीज आप वीडियो देखिए।
And always remember, hold patience, things gonna surely change for better. Hello everyone, I am Rajat, let's open up. May it be Agrima Joshua's and Subham Mishra's controversial case today, or may it be Safdar Hashmi's murder case in 1989. May it be Babri Masjid's demolition controversy, or may it be M.M. Kulbergi's murder case in 2013. In fact, I woke up to this topic after viewing some of the clips yesterday on my Twitter account. Those were the clips of Kharagpur city, West Bengal, where the police brutally did the lathi charge on the women performing pujas at their respective home and also the priest at the temple on the day of Ram Mandir Bhumi Pujan. Okay, there was a shutdown announced in the interstate before, so the public places needs to be shut down. But what did I felt bad was when the police entered into the houses of people and started the lathi charge. I mean, how? Entering into the houses, uprooting the saffron flags, how can one be such intolerant? Okay, fine. Usko wahi rehne dete hain. Mudde pe aate hain. Have you ever thought how this atmosphere rises, the atmosphere of intolerance? Well, the causes are quite nude before us. Number 1. The motivational speeches with the political agendas, where many of the times some politicians create fight between the communities. The religious biases are yet another impact of these speeches. Number 2. The triggered IT cells. I don't know why the people start trolling and cyberbullying those who express views on the religion and Indian society. I mean, why? What's the reason behind that? And the last one, number 3. Misunderstanding or misleading freedom of expression. Freedom of expression will remain under siege unless all groups accept that people can have different opinions and beliefs in a free country. And yet, all this leaves a very high impact on our livelihood or which we experience in our day-to-day life. Intolerance leading to mob lynching, cyberbullying, abusing random people in the internet, spreading hatred against a particular religion, death threats, controversial tweets all around, fear in minorities and many other. So in a nutshell, what I feel is that India's atmosphere is becoming intolerant and it is not at all a myth. Yes, we all are proud. I am proud of all the achievements in different spheres. India has been emerging as a developing nation, but this needs to be stopped. So, what can be done to stop or give a check to intolerance? Let me ask you guys. By removing the party members from a political party who spread biased speech and controversial statement? By imposing severe punishment? By increasing awareness towards the real meaning of freedom of speech? Well, all of this could be done by the government or the political parties if they won. But what's in our hand? What can we do? Increase the civic sense. Most of you have heard it from the childhood days or have gone through the moral science. But irony is that it is the most ignored subject at our school. Civic sense is all about the social ethics. A lot of people assume that the civic sense is just about keeping the roads, the street and the public property clean. No, civic sense is more than that. It has to do with law abiding, respect for fellow men and maintaining decorum in the public places. A small country like Sri Lanka, our neighbor, teaches us many things. They respect the norms of the society, drivers respect the pedestrian crossing, keeps their public places and the public property clean, and yet they stand at 73rd position in the United Nations Human Development Index and India lower at 130. Separatism, vandalism, intolerance, racism, road rage are yet the examples of lack of civic sense in people. People are becoming less and less tolerant to each other, of each other's cultural background, of each other's culture, and other similar traits. The fact is well known to us that India is a diverse country, so we should know to respect the societal norms, respect different people's verdict, and yet we need to develop our civic sense more and more. From the very root level, we need to give our attention towards the subjects like moral science. Parents and teachers should teach their children about the societal norms and respecting the verdicts of people. encourage them to mix with different background people and stop prejudicing them. Also, the parents and the teachers should teach that this proverb, unity in diversity, doesn't only remains in the book, but it is practiced in our real life. The nation always runs peacefully only when the fellow citizens are united among themselves and go within a tune. And by awaring the people out there and looking for a better tomorrow, it does make a sense to me. If you guys find this video 1% relevant, do make sure you share the video with the youth out there, as we are the future to the nation. Do give a thumbs up if you like the content, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow Subhra Talks on the Instagram and Twitter. The link is in the description box below. Yeah, wrapping it up for today. I'll be back again on the next week. Till then, goodbye, namaste, sat Shri Akal, khuda hafiz, #one step towards youth awareness.